If you want to take input from user, you can use scanf. And we have been using the modifier character, that there is percentage d for integer, percentage f for float, percentage l for long, and ld for long integer, and so on, right? So we all know about this terms. I have been delaying this topic because we have not covered strings. So I wanted to wait till I complete string, and then I want to complete this topic. So in today's class, I'm going to cover the topic formatted input output. Basically, I want to talk about formatted output, and you can assume formatted input in the similar way, right? But instead of printf, we will use scanf in case of formatted input. Now I am going to cover. Cut this video in three parts. First part is all about formatted output for integers. Second part is all about formatted output for floats. And last part is all about formatted output for strings. So first, I'll cover formatted output for integers. Now, I have written the first expression, which is common or general expression for formatted output. You can see first is the percentage sign. After percentage flags are there, then there is a width, and then there is a modifier character. You can say, in short, it is F for flag, W for width, and D for modifier characters. Now, what exactly these flags are? Now, I am going to tell you about flags. So, flags can be of two types. First, sometimes you want to justify text. You want to justify it by right or left side. If you want to justify our text by left side, then you can use minus sign. So by default, my text will be in right side, right? So basically, you will not see the difference when you are dealing with the same width. So if the output is here, if I am entering 4-digit number and the width of output is also 4, you cannot guess this justification. But if the width is more than the number itself, then you can see the notice. You can see the change, right? You can see the, or you can notice the difference. So the minus sign is used for left justification. Now, the other flag is zero. Sometimes you want to pad your numbers with zero, like 0, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, or say 1, 2, 3, 4, 0, 0. You want to pad the spaces with zeros. At that time, you can use zero flag. So this is all about flags. Now what exactly the width is? Width is nothing but the output of the width of total output. So I'll show you the example. So don't worry if you don't understand right now. Last is modifier character. So if you are dealing with integer, you can use percentage d. If you are using long integer, you can use percentage ld. And if you are using short, then you can use percentage h. Now I will show you some examples which will cover this concept. So here, first example is x equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. So I have initialized x to some integer value, that is 1, 2, 3, 4. Now I am going to print this x in different formatted output. So what if I am just writing percentage 2D. Now, if you compare this expression with the general expression, you know that this 2 is nothing but the width and D is nothing but the modifier character. And I have not said about any flag, so by default it will be right justified. It will be placed on right side. So, if I am printing something like this here, the width I have given for output is smaller than the actual number. The actual number is having size 4, but the width is 2. So, please don't confuse this output with arrays. This is the single value, but the array stored multiple values. So, please don't confuse it with arrays. This is all about the single variable. In the single variable, if you want to print something, then how it should be printed, that will be covered in formatted output, right? Now, so for 2D, it will be as it is. It will print just as it is answer. But what if someone is writing percentage 60? That means you are giving size 6, but instead of this size 6, you are just storing number with digits 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And it will be by default justified as right direction because I have not mentioned the flag. So, you can say first 2 will be spaces. Here S will not be printed, the spaces will be printed, but I have not, you know, I cannot show you the spaces, that's why I have written S. So in place of that S, actually the spaces are printed. After 2 spaces, it will print the rest of the number. Right? So this is how it will be printed. Now if you want to get more idea about this, you can just open your IDE and type this code. So type printf percentage 60 instead of just percentage D and just check what is the output. Then after, it is minus 60. So here I have used minus flag. And I have already covered that minus flag is used to justify the text in so left direction, right? So by default it is right. But if you want to justify it in left side, you can use minus flag. So instead of that side, it will be just starting with the left, right side, okay? So it will be printing like 1, 2, 3, 4 and then spaces are there. So, we can observe the spaces only when the width is greater than the number itself in case of integers. Now, last but not the least, I have written percentage 060. That means the spaces, instead of the spaces, it will be filled or painted with the zeros. So, here I have not mentioned minus flag. So, by default, it will be right aligned and in right line, it will just print 00, 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is all about formatted output in case of integers. You can assume the formatted input, if you are using it with scanf, right? Now, formatted output with float. So, you can see the general formula for formatted output over here. It will be starting with percentage similar to integers. Then it will be having flag similar to integers. Then it will be having width similar to integers. What will be added for floats? Dot precision. Some students may ask me that, ma'am, what if in case of float, I don't want to print whole 6 decimal places. I don't want to print 6 decimal places, answer up to 6 decimal places. Instead, I just want to print answer up to 2 decimal places on there. So, at that time, if you want to chop up the precision, you can use dot precision. And then after modifier character, which is similar to the integers. So here I am not going to explain about flags, that is minus and zeros, because it is having similar concept or aim just as in it was in integers. Minus sign is used in order to give left justified text and zero is used to pad my number with zeros. But what about the width? So the width is total number of spaces in output. So total size of allocated to my output. Now, precision is new to this float. So, precision is number of digits after decimal point. So, how many numbers I want to write after the decimal point, that will be known by the dot precision. Now, I am going to give you some examples. So, here in my case, x is equal to 12.3456. So, you can see total 6 numbers are there. After decimal, I have written 4 digits. This is one entire number. Now, what if I'm just printing this number as percentage f and then I'm printing percentage fx, what will be written? You know that it will be written as 12.34560 because I know that if I'm percentage F will print up to 6 decimal places. But now I don't want up to 6 decimal places. I just want to print answer up to 2 decimal places. Then I can just write 0.2 like this. So now it will not print up to 6 decimal places. It will just print up to 2 decimal places. So it will print 12.35. Right. Now, if I'm writing 10.2F, here if you compare this expression with the general expression, you know that 10 is the total size, 2 is the, 2 is the precision, that how much precise answer you want or how much digit you want after the decimal point. So total 10 bytes are allocated, or total size 10 is allocated. Instead of this, it will just print something as spaces and then 12.35. So before 12.35, it will just put spaces. You can just execute this program in your computer system or in your ID to check how exactly it look like. So here by default it will be right justified, but if you want to do left justification, you can just put minus before it. So here in the next example, I have written minus 7.2. That means I want my answer to be printed up, correct up to 2 decimal places, and it is having comparatively size, total size 7. Right. So it will be right justified because I have mentioned minus sign. And then after that, last is 4.3F, which will be printed, which will be printing 12.346, right? So this is all about so answer is correct up to 3 decimal places. Please don't confuse the 6 with the 6 in the x, value of x. This 6 is because of the answer. Answer is correct up to 6 decimal places. So this is all about the format and output in case of float. Now I have given some examples that if the value, you have declared variable x as integer and it is having default value of 65, but inside printf you are printing percentage c and then value of a, then it will actually print capital A. And I have already given this example when I was covering the characters. At that time I have shown you that you can print characters based on its ASCII value. Similarly, if I am writing percentage D, so it will be printing 65, right? So based on the modifier character, it will print the answer. Similar way, if I am defining integer A equal to 50, so value of A is 50 in case of integers, but if you are printing percentage X, X is nothing but the hexadecimal, so it will print the hexadecimal value of 15, that is F. So it will print F. Now, how to find hexadecimal or octal of given decimal number? That is not in your syllabus. So, you don't need to understand it right now, right? Just focus on the access character modifiers. And last but not the least, if you are writing percentage O, then it will print 17 because the octal value of 15 is nothing but the 17. So, this is how you can print character, integer, octal, hexadecimal of given integer number or decimal number. Now, last but not the least, we are going to cover about strings. So, because of this topic, I have been delaying this topic till now. Now, as we have already completed strings, I can just head it with this topic. So, this last session, last topic, that is formatted output in case of strings. Suppose I am taking hello world from user and I am going to print it. So, if you count the number of characters in hello world including the space, it is having 13 characters. So if I am writing, just as you can see in the first example, if I am writing percentage S only, that means it will print the entire string. But what if I am writing percentage 50S, right? So you can compare it with the general formula that I have given on the first slide, that is percentage flex. Flex is similar with float and integer. Width is similar with float and integer, but after that, if I am writing dot count or dot something, it is the count, right? So what exactly this count is? How many characters you want to print, right? If I am having 13 characters, but if you have written dot 10, that means among this 13 character, you just want to print 10 characters. So and after that, modifier character. So you can see the second example, that is 15S. So total 13 cutting, no more characters are there in my string, but I am allocating 15, size 15. That means first two bytes or first two places will be occupied by the space and rest of the places will be occupied by the string, right? Because by default it will be right justified. Now what if you want to print it from the next side or from left side? You can just use minus left, right? Here in third example I have shown you that dot 10 as is written. That means among this 13 characters I just want to print first 10 characters. So it will just print something like this. You can just execute this code in your program. So it will just print hello, then comma, then space, and then WOR. Right. The next example is minus 10s. That means I am just giving size 10 and I am starting with the last justification. So it will print hello world entirely, because I have told you if the size of string is given lesser than the actual string or actual size of the output, then it will just print output as it is. If you don't understand this line right now, please just go previous point where I have explained integers. In integers also I have explained this point. Then after you can see 15.10s. That means the actual size of string is 15. It can hold up to 15 characters. But among them, I just want to print 10. So I am allocating size 15. But I want to just print 10. By default, I have not used any flag. So by default, it will be right justified. So it will print SSSSS, 5 times S, because and the rest of the 10 characters as hello world. Right. And last but not the least is minus 15.10. So it is similar to the above example, but here the justification is different, that is left justification, right? Because minus flag is used for left justification. Now, to understand this concept of format and output, I highly recommend you guys to just copy this code inside your IDE and paste it over here and just check what is the output. Then only you will be understood. Right. So please go through the practical session of this code. Try to implement this code by yourself. One advantage of format and output. One can ask that what is the advantage of, you know, this kind of thing. Whenever you want to print a pattern, instead of using spaces, you can use format and output in order to print your pattern. So, if you want to understand this concept, try to implement pattern using formatted output. Then it will be more efficient. I hope you understand this class and this concept. You enjoyed this class. So, we will see you in the next class with a different topic. Thank you so much for attending this lecture. Thank you so much.